This is my latest toy, a Radio Shack TRS-80 micro color computer, model MC-10. Came in the original box, kind of beat up, but it is the original box. You can see some of the features there. It has the basic language built in, 4K RAM of memory, expandable using a little plug-in module, which I didn't get. It has a serial port, which is actually an RS-232 port for connecting a modem or something like that. Cassette port for loading and saving programs. Attaches to any standard TV, has a built-in RF modulator. Unfortunately, does not have direct composite video output. You have to use RF. Includes AC adapter, instruction manual, complete, ready to plug in. So there's the box. And here is the computer itself. You can see it is quite small. There's my hand on it. Here's the manual it came with. And it's a pretty nice manual. It describes, most of it is just teaching you how to use the basic that it comes with. And there's a surprising amount of commands here. It's not a stripped down basic by any means. I mean, you get your standard for next loops and if-then statements, but you can do like data, read, restore, string variables, arrays, you know, all the standard stuff you would expect from your computer. So this really is just a cut-down version of the TRS-80 color computer, which is affectionately known as the Coco. So it uses a Motorola 6803 processor running at a whopping 0.89 megahertz. Yes, it's 890 kilohertz. It's not even 1 megahertz. There's your on-off switch on the back. There's the slot where the extra RAM would plug in. There's the socket for the AC adapter. RF modulator output, which has a switch on the bottom for channel 4 or channel 3. There's the sticker on the bottom. This was made in May 1983. You get a reset button, which isn't actually a hard reset because it doesn't wipe out your program. It's really just a stop button. And there's the serial port and cassette port. And that's about it. The keyboard is a chiclet keyboard, and as you might be able to tell, this was mainly intended to compete with the Timex Sinclair 1000, which was the American version of the Sinclair ZX81, which was sold here in the States for $99, and for a while it was popular just because it was so cheap. But as anybody who's used one of those knew, it was an extremely limited computer. It was black and white only, no sound, a very tiny flat membrane keyboard that was very difficult to type on. So this is basically an improvement on that in every single way except availability of programs. Because this was introduced in 1983 when those very cheap computers were becoming obsolete. Because the real computers like the Commodore VIC-20, the Atari 400, and so on were coming down rapidly in price. So it wasn't too long after this came out that you could buy something like a TI-99-4A for basically the same price. So why would anybody buy one of these little things when you can get a much better computer for not much more money? So it was quickly discontinued in 1984. And Radio Shack only released a handful of programs for it. So it didn't attract much of a following at all. Most people probably don't even know it exists. This was also sold in Europe, in France specifically, as the Matra Alice, which was basically the same thing, except they painted it red. They gave it the French layout on the keyboard. And of course, they modified it for the PAL or even CCAM TV system over there. But basically, otherwise, it was the same as this. So now let's plug it in and show you what it can do. Plug in the power, plug in our RF. And it didn't come with this, but I have a TRS-80 cassette cable, which I'll show you its ability to load programs directly from your computer using the earphone output of your computer. So let's just switch on the TV here. Okay, now switch it on. And there it is. It's black text on a green background, just like the regular color computer, which is definitely not my favorite, but it's okay. The text is 32 columns by 16 lines, also similar to the early color computers, and it can only display uppercase, although you can enter lowercase from the keyboard and send it to the printer and it'll print out in lowercase. On the screen, lowercase appears as inverse video uppercase. So unless you're printing it out on the printer that Radio Shack sold with this, it's not really useful for anything. And one thing I like is that, as you may have seen, the keys have basic keywords on them, but you don't have to use the keys to type in the basic commands. You can type it out in full, unlike the Timex Sinclair. So I can do, for example, 10 print and type quote hello, end quote, and then 20 go to 10. Pretty much the first basic program anybody learned in school. So I'll just run it, and of course it just keeps repeating on the screen until I hit the break key. Here's something a little bit more advanced so you can see its color and sound capabilities. So I'll just hit run here. It has a total of 8 colors available, although unfortunately the text can only show up in black on green. You can't change that. You can only change the color of the graphics characters. Okay, here's a demonstration of loading a program in through the cassette cable, though instead of a cassette recorder, I'm using the headphone output of my PC and a WAV file I downloaded from the internet, because these cassette programs, what people do is they create a WAV file containing the audio of what would have been on the cassette, and then you can just play it through your computer, or I guess you can record it to even an MP3 player or something like that. But I just have it loaded in Winamp here. So what I'm going to do is going to go over to the computer here. So over on the computer here, I'll type in cload, and I'll hit play in Winamp to start playing that cassette image WAV file. And you can see I already recognized the name of the program, Block Drop. And these are short programs. This is only a 4K system, so the programs load pretty quickly. Unlike, say, a cassette that you would load on a Commodore 64 or something like that, which would take a good 5 or 10 minutes to load. These are quick-loading programs. So I'll do a list, and you can see all the commands. Now I'll run it. Okay, it's a little game called Block Drop. Is left and right and spacebar. Object of the game is to catch the falling objects. If your little catcher mitt thing, I guess it would be. Very simple program. If you know you're going to miss something, you can hit spacebar and it sort of bounces it back up to give you a little extra time to try to catch it. So, this system is actually capable of much better graphics than this, although BASIC is limited in its ability to do graphics. You get a lower resolution, so that's why it looks rather blocky. But the highest resolutions, you need that 16K expansion. They won't work in a 4K system. Okay, let me just try to finish this round. There it is. Oh, actually, I won, so it, see, you get less time now to maneuver until you catch it. Sort of like Tetris in reverse. Instead of the bottom building up, the top comes down. But, there we go. Game over. Okay, here's a little demonstration of some of the sounds this can make. It, of course, only has one sound channel, so don't expect any fancy music or anything, but you can do some basic sound effects here. I like that one. That one almost sounds like an Atari 2600. I just typed in this little program from the manual. As typical for Radio Shack Basic, you don't need to type any spaces. So for example, you can just type next Y, X without even needing a space between the next and the Y. So it does save you a little time in typing it in. And it gives you the 8 colors that the system can produce. You get green, yellow, blue, red, white, cyan, although it may look like gray on this monitor, magenta, and orange. So there's my quick look at the Radio Shack TRS-80 micro color computer, model MC-10. A neat little system which was unfortunately pretty much obsolete as soon as it was introduced. So it never really attracted much of a following, although there are a couple websites dedicated to it. You can find some programs to download. And these are pretty easy to find on eBay. And kind of funny that every one I've ever seen on eBay comes with the original box. I guess because people who have bought these back in the day probably just used it like once or twice and then put it back in the box, put it in the closet, and forgot about it for 25 years. So it's easy to find one of these in good condition. And this one's absolutely working perfectly. And another nice little thing is that this is instant restart. I'll switch it off and switch it back on. You can see how quickly it responds. There it is. It's already ready. So, no loading time. There's a size comparison to an Atari 520 STFM, so you can kind of see how small it is in comparison. Also compared to the standard PC keyboard in the background there. So it really does live up to its name of being a micro color computer. Anybody need a Smith Corona 2.8-inch floppy disk?